There are four different methods of centerless grinding, and we choose the one which is most appropriate for the shape, accuracy, and efficiency required for the work. Let's take a look, for example, at the mechanism for in-feed grinding. The workpiece to be ground is held by the blade and the regulating wheel and rotated at a precise speed. Then, while the relationship between the piece, the blade, and the regulating wheel is carefully maintained, grinding takes place as the piece is plunged toward the grinding wheel, revolving at high speed. As the external circumference of the workpiece touches the three points A, B, and C of the grinding wheel, blade, and regulating wheel, its particular round cross-section shape is determined. In other words, it approaches an ideal roundness. As the workpiece is machined by the grinding wheel, its shape approaches true roundness. As the model shows, this piece has a large ridge in the first run. As the wheel continues to turn, the deviations are gradually smoothed out until the piece finally approaches true roundness. We call the effect of this process, by which deviations are gradually reduced, the rounding effect. For example, if the piece is being rounded by 10% per revolution, we can expect that a piece that had an original deviation of 0.1 millimeters will achieve a lesser deviation of 0.5 micrometers in 50 revolutions. Here is the through-feed grinding method. The piece of work is supported by the blade and the regulating wheel and is ground as it passes over the blade while being turned by the regulating wheel. Since the spindle of the regulating wheel is held at a fixed angle in relation to the blade, the workpiece is transported over the blade while forward impetus is imparted by the regulating wheel.